I know I should have told you before. Because you were looking forward to it.
No.
But I had a lot of thinking to do.
Good love, don't worry about us.
But I had to be. Because you're all I've got.
But what about
Sid? Look, all we were looking forward to was your happiness. Now, if something's going to make you unhappy, we want to help. Because we're a team, right? Put the jug on, love.
Wouldn't fit me, B.
Look, love, I know it's none of my business, but I'm going to pack my nose in anyway. What happened? Did Sid call it off?
Oh, no. That wonderful man wouldn't do that. He wouldn't hurt me.
Well, what then?
You remember I told you I had a visitor yesterday?
Yeah.
Well, it was Gordon, Sid's son. And he reckons I'm only marrying Sid for his money and for the house. And if Sid dies, there's no way he's going to let me have it.
What?
Oh, Sid must be a real nuisance to him, staying alive the way he is.
But I don't want the house to be. All I want to do is look after Sid.
Oh, we know that, love. What else did he say?
He reckons there's no way he's going to let an ex-con be the grandmother to his children. And that he hasn't spent all these years bringing them up proper to let me go and ruin it.
Oh, that's charming. Just imagine what the kids are like with a father like that.
No. Sid says they're the tops. That's the worst part about it. He reckons that if we go ahead with the marriage, he'll never let Sid see his grandchildren again.
Yes. Oh, thank you, Mrs. Barfield. Would you mind waiting outside?
Sounds important.
I assume you've heard the news.
Of the wedding?
Yes.
Yeah, just now, as a matter of fact.
I see. Smith, I'm not asking you to break any confidences, but what happened? Sid was very upset when he came to see me, and he didn't say why.
That's because he doesn't know himself, poor old devil.
But
like, I know it sounds crazy, but that's the way it is.
Do you know what happened? If I asked you, would you tell me?
Yeah, okay. I think perhaps we should work together on this one.
Hi. Well, what are you doing in here so early? You're not due until tonight.
Yeah, I know. I just thought I'd come in early, that's all.
Didn't have to do that.
Yeah, I know.
How are you feeling?
Oh, not too bad.
Any clues to who did it?
No, not at all. Look, come on, Terry. You can't fool me. We've been mates for too long. I'm only trying to help.
Yeah, well, the only help I need is to be left alone to work it out for myself.
Oh, for God's sake, why don't you let the cops handle it? They're going to handle it far better than some private crusader.
Look, as long as it doesn't affect my work, it's nobody's business but mine.
But it will affect your work if they get to you again. You and Kathy could end up dead.
Now, it may not be too difficult to replace a prisoner, but it's damn difficult to replace a good officer.
Yeah, well, that's not going to happen, because I'm going to get to them first. You can count on it.
But surely you misunderstood. How could he say a thing like that?
I don't know, Mrs. Davidson. But that's what he reckons.
Well, did you try to reason with him?
I couldn't think of anything to say. He just kept on talking. And nothing he said was true. Honestly, Mrs. Davidson.
Of course not.
Well, why did he say it? I mean, he wouldn't have got that from Sid. Sid wouldn't think like that. And he never met me before, so why does he hate me?
I don't know, Lizzie. Some people don't need a reason. It's just hard to imagine Sid having a son like that.
Yeah. The bludger as good as kicks Sid out of his house. That's why Sid's at home now, on his own. How could a son do something like that, Mrs. Davidson?
Lizzie, you could sign a document disclaiming all right to the house. I dislike giving in to him, but that might keep him happy.
Damn the house. I hate it. I don't want it.
Yes, but he does.
Well, let him have it. Just so long as he doesn't stop old Sid from seeing his grandchildren. That'd kill old Sid. It really would. He reckons the sun rises for them.
Come along, Lizzie. I think you'd better have some rest. You don't look as if you slept very well last night. Thank you, Mrs. Barfield. Lizzie's not feeling very well. I think she should have some rest. Mr. Fletcher, I'm just about to go out. Would you take over, please? Thank you.
You and I are going to have a little talk.
I wish you wouldn't sneak up on me like that. What's the matter with you?
A couple of your friends paid me a little visit last night.
Who? What are you talking about?
Oh, I don't suppose you know anything about it.
No.
I went and saw your friend Dinah. Tried to get her to talk, but she couldn't tell me anything. And then this happened. Now, I want to know who and why.
I tell you, I don't know anything.
Look, Kathy, I got worked over because of you. Now, whether you realize it or not, you know something you shouldn't. People don't just bash up prison officers for nothing. Now, I don't care how long it takes, but you're going to tell me.
Oh, there you are. I've been knocking on your front door. Sid?
Oh, Mrs. Davidson, I'm sorry I was daydreaming.
I'm sure you have a lot to think about.
Yes, but come to a dead end. But there's just no reason for it. I've gone over all that's happened the last few days, but that hasn't helped at all. These are the happiest days of my life.
I know what happened.
It's obviously something I said or did.
I'm sorry, Sid, but I have something to tell you. And I'm afraid it's not very pleasant.
Well, you go ahead and tell me then, Mrs. Davidson. Couldn't be worse than not knowing the reason for all this.
Did you know your son was in town?
Gordon? Well, yes, he's staying with me while he attends a conference. His wife and children were supposed to come today for the wedding.
He came to see Lizzie.
Go on.
I find it hard to believe, but he accused Lizzie of marrying you to gain possession of your home. He also said that if you went ahead with the wedding, he would make sure you never saw your grandchildren again. Normally, I wouldn't interfere.
No, but... no. You're quite right, Mrs. Davidson, to tell me. Look, I hope you won't think me rude, but would you mind leaving me now?
Well... are you sure you'll be all right?
Please, Mrs. Davidson, please, leave.
Well, why would they bother to put somebody in here to keep an eye on you if they didn't think you had some information?
I tell you, I don't know.
Well, try, damn it, try. Look, did you go anywhere where the big boys hang out? Did you see anything, hear anything that didn't mean anything to you at the time?
The only place like that I've been is a pawn shop run by an old fence called Paul Traynor. I didn't know for sure. I'd only heard rumours.
Paul Traynor. Well, did you notice anything? Was there anybody else there at the time?
I can't remember.
Try!
I can't remember!
Look, there's one thing to live with you, but I'm damned if I'm gonna bloody die with you.
You miserable mongrel.
Now, can we go outside, please?